Okay, so as promised, I'm going to show you what I find to be the quickest, the easiest, the simplest method for converting units that'll always get you the right answer, no matter what. And it's very procedural, it's very systematic. And maybe you already know it. Maybe you learned it in high school. I don't know. We'll see. If so, awesome. If not, you're going to learn something new. Okay, so I love to begin asking this question. Whenever I'm teaching unit conversion or the ladder method. And the question is, am I 1 billion seconds old? Okay, now who knows, right? Does any of us have an intuition for what a billion seconds is? I don't. I don't. I can't tell you, well, actually, I've done this problem a million times, so a billion I can tell you, right? But a trillion seconds? I don't know. I have no idea. 100,000 seconds? I can't tell you. We never talk about seconds in that amount of time. You probably use years to talk about that. So how do we turn seconds into years very easily? Okay, so let's ask that question. Am I this guy over here a billion seconds old? Sounds pretty old to me. So whenever we're doing this, we start with something called a ladder method. And whenever I'll write it up here, the ladder method. Okay, and whenever we're using the ladder method, we have a very precise set of steps. Okay, the first step is always to start with what we have. So we have a billion seconds. Okay, we have a billion seconds. And then once we have where we're starting, we always want to remind ourselves, where are we going? Okay. What is the unit that we're trying to get to? So we have seconds, we're trying to get to years. Okay, now we want to convert a billion seconds into some amount of years. All right, so the first thing we want to do is multiply by what's called a conversion factor. All right, and a conversion factor is simply a magic one, right? It's a factor that converts one set of units to another. Now, we don't know how to jump from seconds to years right away, but we know something that's a little bit closer to years from seconds. So, what's the next unit bigger than seconds? You probably would say minutes, right? Okay, so how many seconds are there in 1 minute? There's 60. So, if I multiply this by 1 minute over 60 seconds, okay, now I've multiplied it by a conversion factor, and watch what happens. My seconds cancel out, and now I'm left with minutes. Okay? Why did I put 60 seconds on the bottom instead of the top? Like you imagine that I could probably have done, multiplied this by 60 seconds over 1 minute. If I did that, the seconds wouldn't cancel. You see here I have seconds on bottom and seconds on top. Seconds wouldn't have canceled. That's a no-no. We want seconds to cancel and to be left with the next biggest unit. Okay? And so, great, fantastic. We now have minutes, right? So, what's the next biggest unit of time after minutes that gets us closer to years? Well, you'd probably say hours, and you'd probably be correct. So, I'm going to say that there's 60 minutes in 1 hour. Okay? Again, why did I put minutes on the bottom? Because I want minutes to cancel out so that I'm left with hours, right? Some of you might be wondering, but Scott, aren't you changing the value? And the truth is, no. 1 minute and 60 seconds, that's the same thing. So you're just multiplying by one. That's why we call it a magic one. 1 hour and 60 minutes, it's the same thing. So it's like, the same thing divided by the same thing is just one, right? So you're not changing anything. Okay. We're at hours now. We want to get to years. What's the next biggest, unit of time after hours? Maybe days, right? And we know that there are 24 hours in 1 day, right? And again, hours cancels out with hours, and we're left with days. Okay, the last one I bet you can guess. We don't have to jump to months or something or weeks or anything like that. We know precisely that there are 365 days in 1 year. And now these days cancels out with these days, and I have an answer. How do I get the answer from this? Well, simple as this. Here are all my conversion factors. I want to multiply by everything on the top, right? In this case, it's pretty trivial. You have a billion seconds times 1 times 1 times 1 times 1. That's just a billion. And then you want to divide by everything in the bottom. So divide by 60, divide by 60, divide by 24, divide by 365. Go ahead and do that right now. I'll give you guys a second. So once again, you want to multiply everything on top and divide by everything in the bottom. And you get, at least you should get, 31.7 years. Okay? So a billion seconds is 31.7 years. And so that begs the question, is Scott a billion seconds old? And the sad truth is this summer I just turned 40 years old. So, yes.